Keeping up with our motto, let learning be joy and teaching a pleasure. Here we are with remote teaching and learning process to bridge the gap. Happy learning, students. Here Mrs. Sonal Shah Doshi from Thakur Vidya Mandir High School and Junior College, teaching you all geography today for grade 9, chapter 10, urbanization. Today we are going to learn part 1 of this chapter. So before starting the chapter urbanization, we will do some activity. Before that, what does the following picture indicate? Correct. This is the picture of a village. Now what are the things you can see in the picture? First and foremost, you will say small houses and trees. Scattered houses are there, very far, little far from each other, with good surrounding area, open surrounding area. Now the activity time. What you have to do? Draw the picture of a village in a paper and add the following things after drawing picture of the village. Road connection, railway connection, bridge over the river, a hospital, school, few industries, and theater. Now tell me, is it look like the same? Will you tell the picture a picture of a village? No. So that picture you compare with the previous one, you can see a lot of difference. It may look like this. So what is this process known as? To convert the village into a township, not a city, mega city, but yes, a town. And why it is needed? Correct. It is needed to fulfill our needs, and the process is known as urbanization. Urbanization is a way to convert the village into the town, a process to convert the village into the small town which is having necessary amenities. So urbanization is the process by which large number of people become permanently concentrated in relatively small areas, forming cities. Why this process is needed, students? So let us see first urban versus rural occupations. As you all know, in rural areas, the people are connected with primary sector activities that includes agriculture, fishing, mining, forestry, etc. Whereas in urban areas, most of the people are engaged in tertiary activities like professionals, lawyers, doctors, teachers, etc., while many of them engaged in secondary activities having industries. Now the main occupation, as we looked, of people in rural communities, agriculture, though few people are engaged in non-agricultural pursuits also. Whereas people in urban community are mainly engaged in non-agricultural pursuit like manufacturing, trade, commerce, service and professions. Now think for a while that people of village who are engaged in primary activities, what do they do during seasonal unemployment time? Like they do farming for 2 or 3 months. After that what? They make pots for few months. And after that what? They make umbrellas, woolen clothes, etc. After that what? So they just sit and do nothing and earn nothing? No. They find the job opportunities. Now how do they find? As you know, in village most of the people depend on farming and forestry. So seasonal unemployment will remain. So either they have to migrate for the job or they have to create the job by themselves in the village only. Migration means moving from one place to another for temporary time period. This is a chart of Mumbai, chart of migration. Now, first let us see rural urban migration, how it happens. So rural to urban migration, major cause is due to job opportunity in urban areas. It is a result of push and pull factors. Now what are the push and pull factors due to which villagers do migrate in urban areas? So why they have to leave the village? Those are known as push factors. So it is difficult climate like droughts, struggle to provide food for the family due to seasonal unemployment, very low income of the village when you earn in the village. They only able to own small plots of land and can't afford to fertilizers to increase the yields. What are the pull factors which pull them, attracts them towards the cities? Chances of a better life, better housing, better amenities, chance of good jobs which gives higher salaries and wages. Children are able to go to school because many schools are there in cities unlike villages, and better healthcare facilities like medicines, hospitals, chemists nearby the area you live, etc. So due to this push and pull factor do they migrate. Now think that if they do migration, many people migrate alone as they can't afford to migrate with family and they have to get separated out from the family. So what is the another option? Yes, creation of job nearby only, nearby to the village where they live with their family. How? Just look at this picture. Amul brand, yes. Where is it situated? The factory of Amul? Anand, India. Anand is in Gujarat. It is a small town. Now it was the village prior the Amul factory was situated. And when the factory was situated, it provided job opportunities to the villagers and developed that area and made this small village a town. So creation of job opportunity nearby. So Anand is a small town between mega city Ahmedabad and Baroda, and it is also known as milk capital of India. Now why you know that? Economy of Anand is very vibrant, which ranges from farming to big scale industries. Major crops include tobacco and banana. Now what happened due to that. It is a part to urbanization. You have noticed that because of the factory near the village, the occupation of people of the village has started changing, and more people from outside came and start living in the village. Transport, hotel, restaurant, masses, retail shops, medical services, etc. start developing due to this factory, and as a result the basic structure of the village started changing. It turned into the town. Now looking at our country, agriculture is the main occupation in rural areas, but now various industries have started coming up in rural areas. For example, look at Tata. Okay, example, factories, mills, energy plants, multi-purpose projects, etc. And people come from surrounding regions to work here, and thus population of the village also increases. And to fulfill their needs, other services also develop, like medical facilities, food, hospital, recreation, etc. Like you have drawn in picture 2 during activity time. And consequently, the extent of the village grows and form of earlier village changes into the town, and that is known as the process of urbanization. And what is the role of local government bodies? We need support from government. So as you can see in the picture, they help us in getting sanitization, electricity, other facilities. So the Gram Panchayat providing public services to the village gives way to municipal council or municipal corporation. These bodies provide the different basic services to the citizens, like drinking water, roads, transportation, sewage, network, street lighting, etc. And beside this, other facilities like town planning, recreation, tourist places, park, etc. need to be developed. So consequently, the village transform into the town and then a city. So in this part, we have learned that how the village changes into the township, and the process is known as urbanization. Meet you all in part 2. Thank you all.